Today, we're inundated by surveys and public opinion polls, and not just during election season. Buy something over the internet, you'll probably get an email with the link to a customer satisfaction survey. Take a class at a university, expect a teaching evaluation survey at the end of the semester. Two things are driving this dramatic increase in the use of survey research. First is that new technology has made conducting surveys a lot cheaper. Second, in our new information society, collecting up-to-date data on human behavior is increasingly important. Not surprising, this constant barrage of survey requests has created some skepticism among the public as to the usefulness of surveys and their trustworthiness. But surveys are not being conducted just to annoy you. Surveys cost money, although less than in the past, and are still time-consuming to conduct. So someone thinks this information is important, and you might be surprised how your life is greatly influenced by the results of surveys. The Bureau of Labor Statistics conducts monthly surveys on consumers like you and of retail establishments around the country. This information is used to take a comprehensive appraisal of prices in the U.S. Besides affecting your paycheck, it may influence how much interest you pay on your credit card, car loan, or home mortgage. The Federal Reserve uses the information from these surveys to decide whether or not to raise interest rates. It isn't just your personal finances that are affected by surveys. It's your tax money, too. Where your federal taxes go is partially determined by the data collected by the U.S. Census. The surveys collected by the U.S. Census help determine the amount of money cities and states receive from the federal government. Can't be bothered to fill out the census form? No time? Your county and your state may not get their fair share of over $400 billion of federal funding that is determined, in part, by the responses people give to the U.S. Census. Don't care about money? What about the National Health Interview Survey? The Center for Disease Control and Prevention has been using this survey to monitor the health of the nation since 1957. Want to know how many people don't have health insurance? This survey will help tell you. Not interested in health? What about crime? The National Crime Victimization Survey is the nation's primary source of information on criminal victimization. The survey covers around 90,000 households and contains information on nearly 160,000 people and their experiences with crime. We could go on all day describing how surveys directly or indirectly influence your finances, health, safety, and even happiness. And oh yeah, there are plenty of surveys about happiness. Want to know where the happiest place on earth is? No, it's not Disneyland. According to some survey research, it's Denmark. The World Happiness Report, published by the United Nations, uses survey data to rank 156 countries, and Denmark was the highest-ranked nation for health and happiness 2 years in a row. Remember, the next time someone asks you to complete a survey, it's not just to annoy you. They're likely collecting important information that may have an impact on your life.